styles of Christian music, contemporary praise and worship, I think there's a place for all of it. I really do. And if it has a message and a meaning and it touches somebody's heart and their life, and inevitably if it wins souls to Christ, and that's the bottom line, right?
Amen.
End of discussion. But there has been a movement, I think, over the past 10 or 12 years where it seems as though the old hymns, the sacred hymns church, have been sort of pushed back to the side and almost forgotten. But at the same time, I'm starting to see a sort of a revival taking place with those old songs. Really, and people around the country are starting to incorporate it back into the program because they're realizing that the messages in these songs initially and originally were so powerful and so strong because they were born out of, they were written out of personal tragedy and experiences. And that's why they had so much meaning and impact on us. And that's why they'll always live forever. And I think people are starting to figure this out again. And interestingly for me, I go to a church up in Columbus, Ohio, where I live. I was talking to the pastor's son, he's about 23 years old, the other day, and the prior Sunday, he and two other guys, because of a few people in the church that love Southern gospel music, they said they had been after, would y'all sing a Southern gospel song? And they never do these kind of songs in the church. And so they decided, well, just to pacify this handful of people, we're going to do this Southern gospel song. So they formed a trio. And last Sunday morning, they got up in church, and they started singing, I live in a hill called Mount Calvary.
Amen.
And when they got to the second verse, I want you to know that. And there was about 900 people there that morning, and they come apart.
Amen.
They were up on their feet, cheering and worshiping God and going nuts. And when it got to the last, the part of the chorus where it says, and when time has surrendered and earth is no more, I'll still cling to the old rugged cross. And I thought that place was going to rapture. And I looked over at my wife and I said, it took a Southern gospel song to get the job done. I rest my case.